Hi, everyone, and welcome to Knorr Taste Quest. I'm back, and hot just got hotter. My name remains Manny. Now, the auditions were sizzling hot, but many are called, but the chosen are few. I'm sure that we are ready for a blazing new season of Knorr Taste Quest. So, let's meet our 14 finalists.
Hi, my name is Chini Lozoji. I am a postgraduate student of clinical biochemistry. I love cooking, reading. I also enjoy traveling a lot. Knorr Quest to me is going to be quite an experience because as a biochemist, what we basically do is manipulate so many elements and watch them being converted into chemicals and just like that have a job. It's almost like magic, and I hope to use this magic touch as an edge over other contestants in being able to manipulate so many ingredients, no matter which background they are from, and get something palatable out of it.
Hi, my name is Dom Ihansaken. I'm an engineer and a fashion designer. I love to cook. I love to experiment in the kitchen. When I'm in the kitchen, I'm happy. I love to make different things with different ingredients, experiment, engineer stuff in the kitchen, bring people together to try it out. So when I'm on the show, I look forward to creating different things from the ingredients I'm given and making something delicious and wonderful out of it.
Introducing Victor Akwajibo, aka Victory. I'm an entertainment personality, adrenaline junkie, and of course, creative kitchen hand. For me, food is art and an adventure, and I look forward to having an awesome time on the Taste Quest show. We see this. Look out.
Hi, my name is Mwando, Mwando Wanjibo. I'm a veterinary doctor with a master's in veterinary public health. I love cooking, I love blogging about food, and I really, really love eating. Don't be deceived, even though I look slim, I really love eating. I look forward to enjoying the show, and I look forward to making you enjoy the show. Watch this space.
Hello everybody, my name is Olabode Akinyola. Those that know me is your boy Kinzo. I'm a systems analyst and a Yoruba boy from Oyo State, Ibadan. For me, cooking was the regular Sunday to Sunday barbecue once people started liking my chicken and I had to start analyzing my chicken. I look forward to having fun, making a dish people haven't seen before, and I want people to want to know how I did it. I look forward to cooking something out of this world and people enjoying it. I just want to have fun basically. So cooking and having fun, that's what I want to do.
Hi, my name is Olakunle Gibson. I'm an office administrator in Lagos. I enjoy watching television, most especially cooking shows. I've always dreamed of being on a cooking show. I guess I'm living my dream now. My motto in life is short. Be the best you can, and do the best you can.
Hello, my name is Veronica Mwazo. I'm a statistician by training and event planner by profession. One thing I love about the two is the connecting factor. While on the Knorr Quest show, I'm looking forward to a lot of things, meeting new people, knowing how to cook, you know, with time and all. But most importantly, learning new things, because I believe that every day is the learning process. So watch out for me on the Knorr Quest show.
I'm Charles Achibo from CrossFit State. I'm a creative designer. I love art. I love cooking, and I wish to bring my form of art into cuisines and plating. And for the Knorr Quest test, I'm just here to have fun.
My name is Chinez Ziako. I'm a graduate of business administration. I like traveling. I like eating. I like food. I like everything concerning food. And I also like music. Coming into this contest is an avenue for me to try out all my experimental recipes, even the ones I've not tried out, and see how it goes. I also came here to have fun as well.
Hello there. My name is Kofola Bolaji. I am a business consultant. I study contractual management. I love cooking, reading, and traveling. I'm here to learn more on cooking techniques, meeting new friends, having fun, and sharing ideas. And above all, hope to be the best.
My name is Omonji
Ojo.
I'm a seafarer. I work on the sea, I stay more on the sea than on land. I have a great passion for food. I love cooking. I've been doing this great art, perfecting it, learning it over the years. And I say it has been a wonderful experience for me. Here I'm on this show to bring out those experience, those things I've learned and creativity. And hopefully, you're going to have a nice and wonderful experience seeing the new recipes that we put together.
There they are, the season's culinary warriors, coming from the brand that brings flavor home to you, your cooking, and your kitchen. It is Knorr Taste Quest. So what's at stake here? A brand new Ford SUV, courtesy of Koscharis Motors. 2 million naira in cash. Kitchen equipment, courtesy of Kenwood. And other fantastic prizes and the bragging rights as Nigeria's culinary best. But we're not here alone. We have our professionals on this, so let's meet our judges. Starting off with our executive chef, Dr. Robert.
In season one, we had contestants that pushed the limits, fought very hard, and the best emerged the winner. In season two, having gone through the auditions, I'm convinced that we have an even better crop of contestants who shall push those limits. In my kitchen, we're hot, just got hotter.
Up next is our sous chef. He is the face of his generation, Chef Frags.
This season, I'm just looking forward to contestants who are even going to push the boundaries and the bounds even more and show us crazier things, so to speak. I'm excited to see how they're going to handle the heat in a kitchen where hot just got hotter.
Now wait for it, wait for it. We do have a second sous chef on our judging team. Her passion for cooking led her to culinary school to become a professional chef. A well-rounded Le Cordon Bleu College of Culinary Arts graduate, Chef Renee Chooks.
I'm super, super excited to be a judge on the Knorr Taste Quest show this season. And I'm looking forward to seeing individuals who are going to blow my mind, show skills that are just beyond this world, and of course, an outstanding individual to become Nigeria's culinary best.
Yeah, a female touch to the judging process. So cool. But stay with us. It's Knorr Taste Quest, and hot will get hotter after the break.
Cubes are here.
And the flavor is 3 times meatier.
3 times?
Yes.
I can't wait to start cooking.
Joyce, what special flavor do you put in your stew? And how come you're always having so many customers?
It's the new Knorr Cubes, so.
No?
The new Knorr Cubes flavor is now 3 times meatier. Taste some.
I think I'll have some more.
Taste the Knorr difference, now with 3 times meatier flavor.
Welcome back to Knorr Taste Quest, our search for Nigeria's culinary best. All right, guys, come on in. Congratulations!
Thank you.
We're jumping straight into it. Are you ready?
Yes.
It's time. Dr. Robert.
Congratulations on getting this far, all 14 of you. Welcome to the kitchen, where hot just got hotter. Please go to your stations. In front of you, ladies and gentlemen, is your first major task to perform. Memories of what got you here. Hot spicy pepper, onions, and green peppers. Today you have 5 basic ingredients. You have liver, tomatoes, a cocktail of peppers, sweet chili peppers, hot spicy pepper, green peppers, you have onions, you have lemon, and you have rice. In 40 minutes, we expect you to cook a hot, tasty dish using every single ingredient in front of you, and of course, Knorr. We must taste your lemon, your peppers, your onions, your liver, your rice, everything must be tasted. On my right side, there is a dry goods pantry with a limited stock of dry goods. On my left is a wet goods pantry with also a limited stock of wet goods. They are yours to use and to share. Remember, you will plate your dish in four places. You'll be judged on simple things: how you keep your workstation clean, how your food tastes, how your food is presented, and most importantly, how you have used the brand Knorr in your cooking. And the time starts now.
These ingredients, Dr. Robert?
I was thinking that liver that is so full of vitamins, it's a good source of protein, unfortunately very high in cholesterol. But then again, if you now take that and you throw in lemon, which is full of vitamin C and fantastic for you in all its ramifications, then I guess you can balance both off. What would you do if you had those ingredients to cook with lemon and liver?
Frankly, I wouldn't know what to do because I think the lemon really throws, because like you said, most of the ingredients are your regular tomatoes, pepper, everything that we see in the market and we use in our daily cooking. But lemon is so used to probably wash, you know, your snails or something. It's interesting to see what they would do. But if I put my thinking cap on, I use it to flavor the rice. I use it to maybe marinate my liver. What do you use to make your sauce?
Peppers, chili peppers, sweet peppers are, if I'm correct, full of amino acids, full of vitamins and things like that. How would you combine those in the ingredients?
Well, I mean, you want to do a slight sauté with those because if it's spicy peppers like chili peppers, you don't want that heat going raw into anybody's mouth. So you want to put that through a little bit of, fire heat first, so that it tempers down whatever chili.
Why not somebody just do a simple, basic jollof rice? You have your peppers, you have tomatoes, you have onions, you have liver, you have rice. That's jollof rice.
Yes.
The heat is on.
I love cooking, that's what I'm going to do.
He says he can cook.
Well, I know what to cook. I just pray you enjoy my food.
Let's wait.
It's not a matter of prayer. It's a matter of making it awesome. So, because I'm not going to pray for you.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, stand back, stand back.
It's the moment of truth.
Cubes are here.
And the flavor is three times meatier.
Three times?
Yes.
I can't wait to start cooking.
Joyce, what special flavor do you put in your stew? And how come you're always having so many customers?
It's the new Knorr cubes, so.
Knorr?
The new Knorr cubes flavor is naturally times meatier. Taste some.
I think I'll have some more.
Taste the Knorr difference, now with three times meatier flavor.
Chinelo, tell us how you've used your ingredients, most especially your lemon.
Okay, I used it when I was caramelizing my onions and green pepper. So I put in a dash of lemon into it before I put in my parboiled liver. And
why did you choose to parboil your liver?
Liver, from the time I've been cooking it, it's tough. Yeah, so it has to be parboiled first.
Interesting. And what do you call this dish you've made?
These are five-colored rice.
Five-colored rice?
Yeah.
I'm gonna count.
And what are the five colors?
The white, the brown, the orange, the red, the green.
Where's the brown?
The meat.
I can taste one flavor. That's pepper. And your liver is very tough. You know, you can spoil food by making it too peppery because all we can really taste is plenty of chili. So I cannot even taste the Knorr, I can't taste the lemon, I can just taste fire in my mouth. Okay? Thank you very much.
Thank you.
This is my version of a Thai stir fry.
Your version of a Thai stir fry. Can you tell us, please, very importantly, how you have used your lemon in this Thai stir fry?
I used a piece of the lemon in the stir fry when I had almost done towards the end, and a bit of it in the rice.
So the bit you put in the stir fry, was that the zest, the juice, the pit?
The juice.
The juice.
Yes.
So if I taste the stir fry, will I taste the lemon in it?
You should.
I should do.
Yeah. You put lemon in your rice?
Yes.
The liver is cooked, honestly, to perfection.
Mm-hmm. Yes, I've never tasted lemon. Yeah. It's good in my
That's food. How the liver is meant to be cooked, not parboiled, sauteed to a point whereby it melts in your mouth and gives you the feel that, oh my goodness, I want to have some more.
Yeah.
Honestly, you have surprised me by doing very well. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
It's a stir fry liver with rice and mashed potatoes.
So many flavors at the same time is floating in your mouth.
Can you put lemon in your potato?
Yeah, I squeezed a bit.
In your potato?
No, not when I was mashing, when I was doing the oven.
It's white in the potato.
It has a lot of flavors coming together.
So many, huge ones.
A lot nice flavors,
yeah,
too.
But funnily enough, very nice flavors.
I think that the potatoes in their own, a good meal, and the rice in their own, just don't go together for me.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
I made a lemon marinated liver stir fry sauce.
A lemon marinated liver stir fry sauce. Going along with what?
With all the ingredients that we're giving. There's garlic in the marinade as well.
With white rice.
And I added Knorr ordinary and oil inside it.
Maybe you had cooked your liver for 7 minutes less, it may have been perfect.
Perfect.
It may.
It's overcooked right now.
But all I can taste really in your food is vegetable oil.
Thank you very much.
I've made a risotto style rice with pan fried liver and surrounded by a pepperade sauce.
Okay. Say that to me one more time.
Risotto style rice.
What's risotto style rice?
It's when rice is a kind of rice cooked in cheese, milk, and stock. And sometimes.
And what do you call the surrounding?
A pie parade.
Come again, ma'am?
A pie parade. Pie parade.
A pie parade.
Yes.
The risotto should be creamy and.
There's a battle going on in your liver.
I've never had liver. So tough. In my entire life.
I like. Did you put garlic or something in the rice?
Yeah,
I like the hint of, you know, the garlic in the rice.
The rice has a good taste. It just shouldn't be called risotto. That's what
I think. Yeah, that's all. And this pie parade thing should just have water, at least hot water in it.
When you were cooking in the kitchen, I was like, wow, she has this thing going. But the end result has been a disappointment.
Yeah.
If I throw this liver against the window, it will break the window. Thank you very much.
I cook a stir-fried rice with butter and corn oil. Then I stir-fried the liver in butter and garlic.
How did you use your lemon?
The lemon, I squeezed the lemon on the liver by stir-frying it, and I also squeezed the lemon on the rice after stir-frying it.
I didn't get any joy from eating this.
I think the nicest thing on your plate is the tomato.
Wow. And that didn't have to be cooked.
Yeah, that's the nicest thing on your plate. Thank you very much.
Liver, mushroom.
Can you speak up so we
liver,
can hear you?
Liver, mushroom, and vegetable stir fry.
Liver, mushroom, and vegetable stir fry. And where's your liver in all of this?
It's in the rice.
And how have you used your lemon?
I use just a little bit to boil the liver.
Madam, if you want to win a brand new SUV, you use a little bit of my main ingredient, my spanner, lemon, a little bit.
What are these vegetables steamed? What vegetables are these steamed?
Steamed, I use this to garnish it. The side veg just to garnish.
What vegetables
it.
You
for liver.
Do you know what I'm doing here too? I'm looking for liver.
I see a lot of mushroom.
And yeah. Madam, see, look at. In this entire bit of rice I have scattered on my plate, you can see. This is all the liver inside.
It's pink.
It's unfortunate that the liver is nice, but
no taste.
No flavor.
No taste. No, it's cooked well, but no flavor. Yeah. Thank you.
I made a boiled rice, clean boiled rice, and a sweet sauce. I didn't make it too peppery.
And a sweet sauce.
Yes.
How did you use your lemon in all of this?
I was about to use the lemon when you said tempeh.
So in other words, you didn't use the lemon?
No, I had cut it, but I didn't use it.
And you said your sauce wasn't supposed to be spicy, but
it is. The heat is unbelievable. And not heat of fire, heat of pepper.
Nothing too out there. The sauce was almost there, but it's sweet on one half, then it's hot on the other side. And the rice could have done with a touch of salt.
Thank you very much.
On the plate is compound rice. Stuffed in pan roast bell peppers, and on the side is a stir-fry liver sauce with sweet chili sauce.
With sweet chili sauce. How have you used your lemon?
Okay, the lemon was the marinade for the livers, and the lemon also came into the rice, and also lemon is the sour in the sauce.
What's in the rice?
Okay, there's butter, there's cream. That's Knorr.
Yes, you're the one that put the cream in the butter. I saw that.
What Knorr did you use?
Knorr chicken.
Your rice is actually, funnily enough, it doesn't look appetizing, but it tastes very good.
But when you say you're going to stuff something next time, make sure it's stuffed. Yeah. Now it's spilling. It's spilled.
I think that was part of his presentation.
It is?
That's right.
Ah, right.
It's because he only had one bell pepper, so he decided to find a way to.
What sauce is this? There's.
Okay, this is like a sweet chili sauce.
Did you make it yourself?
Yes, I did.
I remember you making that sauce.
You know, he knows you like sauce. So he has given you sauce
and, speaking about
and more sauce,
sauce. I want the recipe of this whole thing right here. I think it's really good.
It's excellent. The one singular thing is you needed 5 seconds less for your liver.
Yes.
Everything else is perfect, but the liver has been cooked one notch too much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, boss.
I made for you a Knorr jambalaya.
And yeah, on the side, a fresh salad infused with lemon juice. Two vegetable salad. I'm sorry, that's all I could find.
Okay, wait. I made you a rice and a salad. He made you a Knorr jambalaya.
I like that note.
And a lemon infused salad.
No, two lemon infused, two vegetable salad.
Two vegetable salad. Yeah. Okay. Cool. I can already see the. I can see the fire.
Fire. No, there's no fire.
I'm afraid to put it in my mouth.
It's not that hot.
Not that hot? I can see a little big Mexican hat coming around my head now.
Or your sombrero.
Yeah. You know, it does have that kind of Mexican feel to it.
It does.
Honestly speaking.
It does.
I'm not even going to attempt to eat your two vegetable salad. Mm-mm. Look at how you have plated the food. Come on. You wouldn't go to a restaurant and pay to eat this. No, it's not the plate. It's how you put the food on the plate.
So work on your plating skills.
Thank you very much.
Okay, thank you. Tell me, what have you cooked?
Red liver in tomato sauce, the sauce I didn't serve with fried rice.
You didn't serve the sauce?
Yes.
What happened? You didn't have enough time?
That was the last time I should have put.
That's the last thing that you should have put, okay?
You said grilled liver?
Yes.
Yeah. And fried rice, you said?
Vegetable, yes.
Thank you very much, sir.
Okay, I did a liver and vegetable stir fry with whole cotton mushroom with steamed rice with rice, lemon infused.
So the rice has no taste. The liver is soft and powdery. It just doesn't make any sense. That's the reality. And you know that this is a competition. So if you can't bring your A game, you can't be here. Thank you very much.
Yes, I made vegetable rice and
made what?
Sorry, you need
vegetable
to
rice and tomato liver sauce.
So vegetable rice with a liver sauce. And a coleslaw by the side. How do you use your lemon?
I use my lemon two ways. I use one for a garnish and in the liver sauce.
The one problem I have with this, first of all, is the fact that the liver is chopped into a little bit. And that's like a main ingredient, so you don't get to actually taste how well he cooked the liver.
I can taste liver in the sauce. I can get that liver flavor. But again, now I get the powder as well because you've cut it so small.
It's overcooked.
It's now overcooked.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
I've made some white rice and my version of a stir fry.
Sorry, can you say that again?
I've made some white rice and my version of a stir fry.
And your version of a stir fry. What is your version of a stir fry?
Well, typically, stir fry will have Asian spices, but I've made do without them. That's why I said it's my version.
Okay. I beg to disagree, but that's okay.
That's fine.
What else is in your white rice?
As you guys going to ask the same question.
So you can say it's white rice, because then you put eggs in it. It's not rice. Plain white rice.
What did you put? You made
It's egg boiled rice.
Egg fried rice. Or
egg. No, egg boiled
rice. It's not fried. It's
anyway,
cold.
The rice is good, though.
Well, thank you very much.
The results after this timeout.
This is the first time I'm seeing 40 minutes go by like a few seconds. I made a few mistakes, which I learned from, and I hope it gets better.
I've actually learned my lesson from now. I actually have to work with what I see.
I pray I scale this. I'll be able to do better next time. That's just my prayer.
The time went very fast, that's all I could say. Well, I hope to progress to the next round.
The time limit was problematic to me.
Time was just your little. I think time. But I know that's what competition is all about.
Time factor and all that. If I have an opportunity to stay, I have to up my game.
The kitchen was very hot. I couldn't manage the time very well.
I have to work better on my skills on cooking protein, especially animal protein.
I spent most of the time running around looking for the ingredients I needed.
Next time we'll make it better within a quicker time.
It's so much to do with limited time, but of course,
It's a competition and we're expected to bring our A game.
I know if I survive this episode, next time I will manage my time more.
I'm just looking up to Grace.
Welcome back to Knorr Taste Quest, our search for Nigeria's best. It's time to find out who the real contenders for this season are.
My new Knorr cubes are here.
And the flavor is three times meatier.
Three times?
Yes.
Fun. I can't wait to start cooking.
Joyce, what special flavor do you put in your stew? And how come you're always having so many customers?
It's the new Knorr cubes, so.
No?
The new Knorr cubes flavor is now three times meatier. Taste some.
I think I'll have some more.
Taste the Knorr difference, now with three times meatier flavor.
Can you all come forward, please? What a disaster. 40 minutes, basic ingredients, to cook something that could even have been jollof rice that your grandmother and great-grandmother has cooked for you over and over and over and over and over again. And not one person could impress us.
Can I have Charles? Moses Brown, Kumbi Dixon, and Chineze. Unfortunately, this group failed to really show promise and didn't meet my expectations, didn't meet our expectations. So it's Charles, for example, your food had failed, but that potato, everything wasn't just really working. Mr. Brown, it was just not even hitting the spot. The stir fry wasn't the biggest success. And as for you, Chineze, your whole dish just felt very uninspired and very oily. So, unfortunately, all of you are still here, though.
Yes. Can I have Olabode Akinyola, Popola Ogunbomi, Nwando Onuibo, Omoni Ojo. Anyways, you are safe for another week, so let's see what you can do, all of you.
All four of you. Thank you. Doom. Honestly, you shocked me. And that is a fact. You shocked all three of us. Your food was almost perfect. If you keep it up, you have a place in the last three. You're safe. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Victor, the man in the shorts, you promised me your A game, and in all actuality, you came with the A game. You did the best of all 14 today.
Thank you.
Congratulations for being best in show today.
Thank you both.
On behalf of the brand, Knorr Taste Quest, you have won 20,000 naira for yourself.
Thank you. How about you, Stacey? Antia Bassi, I'm so sorry. Your journey ends here. Please let me have your knives. Thank you very much. Chinello, you are safe. Adetola Kende, cooked food that I don't know if you thought it was for me or for Chef Rex, Chef Renee, or maybe it was for somebody else. You're on probation. Which means that if for any reason you fall in the bottom three next round, you're out.
But today, you are safe.
Veronica, I really, really like the idea you were going for today. It was good. You know, I told you half of the sauce was sweet, half of it was spicy. You had, when I heard what you said was going on, I thought, wow, okay, this should make sense. Unfortunately, the lemon wasn't in there. The dish was so disjointed and you didn't use a key ingredient. So unfortunately, this is the end of the road for you.
Can we have your knives, please?
Let's have your knives.
Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, what a disgrace. If you thought today was hard, I promise you, this time next week, another four of you are going to go home. And hot just got hotter. Thank you.
It's a wrap for today, but join us same time next week as the quest continues for Nigeria's best. It is Knorr Taste Quest. And for those of us at home, you know with Knorr, everyone is a winner. That is the reason why every week there are prizes to be won by the viewers. Just answer the weekly question correctly. This week's question is, who won the maiden edition of Knorr Taste Quest? A, Sorato. B, Lalu. C, Bolariwa. Who was it? If you know the answer, text your answer in this unique format. Text RR, then your answer if it's A, B, or C to the short code 33120. Text RR, then your answer if it's A, B, or C to the short code 33120. The first 20 correct entries will get exciting prizes from Knorr. And we want to hear from you guys, so please like our Facebook page, send us your comments and your favorite recipes. And we say a very big thank you to our co-sponsors, Coscharis Motos and Kenwood. And a bigger thank you to the most amazing judges that we know, Dr. Robert, Chef Regs, and Chef Renee. I'm your host, Manny, and I'll see you all same time next week on Knorr Taste Quest. Goodbye.